Everybody. It's the weekend, and that's always usually a good thing. I wanted to come on today to talk to you about a couple of new products that I had purchased, used, talked about one, and a new one that I just received. And I just finished doing my makeup and to get ready for the day, and I thought, you know, I think I'll just come on and do a quick little video, show you what I used, and kind of share a couple of tips, not my tips, but just share with you a couple of tips that I've incorporated into my routine, and I think they're pretty helpful. So I think I'll start with that, and then I'll get on to showing you what I have on my face, how I did my face today, and my tips. Now, this happens to be the deep cleanser with red clay skin rescue that I like to use in the shower, and it's really helped with it slips my mind right now, those little bumps sometimes that you get. I don't know if it's just like a combination of dry skin, but I like to use this in the shower for that area because it really, really helps with that. And my tip is this: whenever you have any products in a tube, what I like to do is when it gets down to the end and I can't squeeze any more out, I like to snip the tube, and I take my spatula, which I purchased this at Sephora, and I just scrape it down so that it can get down into the nozzle so that I can use every bit of it. And as you can see, I pretty much have most of it scraped down in into the open area, and then I rinse the top out really, really good and clean, and then all I do is I stick the top back over it, close it, put it back in my shower, and I use up every single bit of it. You know, product is expensive, and to me, I think this is pretty wise to do. You're still keeping it intact and covered, and sometimes the buildup inside the tube is like enough for a good 5 or 6 extra washings or uses, sometimes even more. There's a lot of products sometimes that you squeeze and squeeze and you can't get any more out, and this is just a great tip, and I do it quite often. Second tip I have that's not my tip, but I've incorporated into my face regimen, is I like to take loose powder after I've primed my face, of course washed it and did all that and primed it. I like to take loose powder and lightly put the powder, tap it into my face, and just buff it in, and then I follow with foundation or BB cream or whatever it is that you're using, and it keeps my skin matte, it keeps it the oils down, and I have no problems putting makeup on. Now, when I first started doing it, I can tell you that it was bad, didn't come out right. I think I was applying way too much powder, but a very light, and I tap it on right over my primer after my primer's settled and dried, and then I just buff it, and that's it. Then if I feel like I'm really oily, or it's, you know, outside environment, hot, humid, know I'm gonna probably spill out extra oils, I just take that brush and go over it, right over my T-zone. Second tip. Third tip, and this is from, I saw it on a video with Wayne Goss, and I've used this tip several times. Now, I can't do it as well as he does it, but I do it for purposes, because I wear glasses, it's hard to see that fine line in there. This really helps. What you do is you take, oh, this is my eyebrow brush. I don't want that. I happen to be using the Chanel eyeliner. And what I do is I take that eyeliner and I bring it up. And these Chanel eyeliners are awesome. They don't run, they last all day. And they even have a little sharpener down at the end here. It's awesome. Well, oops, you take it out if you have to sharpen the tip and refine it for yourself. It's really awesome. But what you do is you take your eyelash curler, and this is a, I always want to say Shiseido, but it's not Shiseido. I'll link it below. A great eyelash curler. I invested in this eyelash curler a couple of years ago. It's the same one. They add a couple of extra rubber tipping. Honestly, this is probably, I change it out like once a year because it cleans super well and it just works beautifully. So, anyway, you take your eyeliner pencil and your curler and you run it on the lower bottom rim here. I don't know if you can kind of see the marking there, but you just run it across there a couple of times. And what you do then is you place it onto your eyelashes, crimp down, and kind of just press it into your skin area. And what it does, it's kind of like a stamping, and it will draw that little line so close to your lash line. And for me, the reason I do it is so I can see that lash line better when I don't have my glasses on and I can draw that line in. It's a really great tip. Now, I've watched Wayne Goss's video and him do it, and he gets like this perfect eyeliner line on it. So I don't. I'm just doing it to just see the outline of it works great. And then I can just stay right inside that and go over it. And it's perfect. So that is my third little tip. So I just wanted to share that with you because I thought those were kind of fun. And today on my face, of course, after washing and everything, I have the Hourglass primer on that I use all the time. I've showed it. It's the Mineral Veil primer. Love it. And I'm getting down to the nitty-gritty, so soon I'll be snipping it and getting every last bit out of that tube. And then today I went ahead and I am using my Makeup Forever HD Ultra. It's a stick. I love it. I use this. I'm not just wearing my normal traditional BB cream from Clinique. And of course, the loose powder that I happen to use to set under my eyes is Laura Mercier, and then my face, I use Chanel loose powder. I love that powder. It just has, it's milled so silky, and it sits on your skin so well. And then I showed this Sweetie Pie in a video that I just did last week. It's really beautiful. And I have that on the apples of my cheek here. And what I did to just contour a little bit down through here is I took my Chanel angled contour brush. And I just kind of went in this dark area here and just sort of contoured a little bit and then swirled around and used it on the apples of my cheek. And today, my eyeshadow is Chanel, and I've shown this before. I absolutely love it. It's called Memory, and it really is beautiful. That's what I have on my lids as a base. So I started with it. And then I went with this new Becca eyeshadow palette. It is huge. I'm not going to show you the mirror to it because it's down there. But look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? These colors, ooh, so pretty for fall. They are really, really beautiful. So, what I did after I put on the Chanel Memory was I went ahead over it with this color here. And this color is, you know, I wanted to show you the shadow combination, how pretty it is. So, I'm putting my glasses on. Ooh, make it a lot easier. So, I started with this light color here, and it's called Rose Quartz, and I brought it into the outer V of my eye and started my creasing with Rose Quartz. And then I went over it with this color here, just lightly, Hot Cocoa, and I played around with it. yesterday a little bit, and that hot cocoa just alone on your lids is really pretty. And then underneath my brow area, I went in with this pearl, and it's really pretty. It's not real shimmery, and it's just really nice, and it blends all these shadows blend out so beautifully, so well. In the corner of my eye, I went with topaz. And so I'm going to show you these three that I used. And as you can see, they're really, really pretty. Really, really pretty. And they do, I'm going to pick up a little bit more of this rose quartz. And I want to show you this cocoa color because they're so, so pretty. Blendable, soft, like no fallout. Just really a beautiful, beautiful palette. So that's from Becca. And paired up with Sweetie Pie, that's my look for today. So, not anything fancy. Oh, and on my lips today, I got a sample of Tarte's. This is called Colada. And this is really right in line with Ball. It's very pretty. And then I went over it with this Butter London that seems to really be the perfect gloss over these fall lipsticks that I've been wearing lately. So that's it, guys. Just wanted to come on and share a little bit about a couple of new things. And as a sample, in a last purchase, I selected this perfume. It's called Book, and I'm so sorry I don't have the little slip that came with it that tells the notes in it, but boy, is this something so different for me. It truly, truly is. I can't even describe it. It's not florally. It has a little bit of it's nature, woodsy, a slight hint maybe of musk. I know I read the notes on it, and you know, sometimes that there will be something in there that stands out that I'll think, oh no, not for me. This smells beautiful. It's light, and you just get that nice little glimpse of it. But I ordered the spray bottle because I thought, oh, when this is gone, I'll miss it. So, and I've been liking the little spray bottles that Sephora offers, and I know usually at Christmas they'll put a set together where there's several. What a great way to really experience a new scent, to see if it agrees with you, if you really like it, and then if you do, you can go further and buy a bigger bottle. But I just think it's great, and this one happens to come in the spray bottle, so I did order it. And I want to mention quickly, because I am going to do a video on this. This is brand new, and I just want to say this. Listen, this just isn't for gals my age. This is for 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s. If you have dark circles under your eyes, which most all of us do, college students, high school girls, pulling all-nighters, studying, new moms, you know, just being tired, allergies, having a day where you're just not feeling quite well. Well, where does it show on your face? Your eye, this under eye area, the most delicate skin tissue that you have on your face. It gets overlooked, and I think so many times it just gets abused, you know? We're rubbing our eyes, we're sneezing, we're just constantly, you know, not really paying quite attention when we're sleeping on our pillows, we're, you know, squishing our faces. But dark circles, puffiness, brand new from Rodan and Fields, and coming out in November, brand new. As a consultant, of course, I have it. I have used this product 6 times, morning, night, morning, night, morning, night. And I want to tell you that this is just beauty in a tube. Just a small teardrop amount underneath your eyes at night, in the morning, before applying your makeup. Amazing. I am thoroughly amazed at the results. And when I do the video on this to talk to you a little bit more about it, or maybe I'll do it in here, I'll go ahead and put in a picture. Before I started really using good eye treatment and using multifunction eye cream by Rodan Enfield since February of this year till now, you can see the difference in the graduation and how my eye area has improved. And in 6 treatments, just of this is a 2-month supply, I'm amazed at how refreshed and bright-eyed my skin area looks just when I wake up in the morning. And right now I'm having some issues with allergies and sinuses, so these circles have gotten pretty pronounced, but a great product. I just can't even, I can't begin to tell you how excited I am to use this whole tube, because I know the results are going to be absolutely amazing. So if you're interested at all, message me and I'll get with you and talk to you about how to get this into your regimen, because this is good for everybody. Dark circles, puffiness, and fine lines and wrinkles. So if you like this video, hey, give it a thumbs up, because you know, I heard that YouTube doesn't really play all the videos that you might post, or it goes out to your, you know, little followers. And I have such a small little following, but I do YouTube because I enjoy it. I love sharing some of what has been shared with me that I've come across, and maybe someone else hasn't. So I love these little tips. I love to share some of the newer products that I use and the older products and some of my favorites. And so I don't usually say, hey, subscribe or give me a thumbs up, but maybe I should, so it gets played a little more, and maybe some of these tips you'll incorporate into your regimen. So until next time, have a great weekend. Be kind, be humble, and age gracefully.